Hello everyone, welcome to sqadia.com. I'm Dr. Hina Khan and today we're going to discuss the allergic conjunctivitis. So this condition, which is known as allergic conjunctivitis, is primarily caused due to the allergens in our surroundings or in our environment. It can be the physical antigens, for example, the dust mites or the pollen grains. On the other hand, it can be the internal autoimmune mechanism of that particular patient. It can be the deficiencies of the patient that basically flares up an allergic conjunctivitis in that particular patient. We'd be discussing the simple allergic conjunctivitis first of all. So a typical case of allergic conjunctivitis, when we are dealing with that particular case, what are the clinical features we are looking for? The treatment modalities that usually come in our mind, we'll be dealing or we'd be discussing that over here. We would be outlining the vernal keratoconjunctivitis, another variant of allergic conjunctivitis. The vernal keratoconjunctivitis is basically caused due to the warm, the hot and the humid climates, as well as the spring catarrh can also infiltrate this kind of vernal keratoconjunctivitis. Then we usually have an atopic keratoconjunctivitis, which is basically an adult form of vernal keratoconjunctivitis. We have another variant of allergic conjunctivitis, which is the giant papillary conjunctivitis, triggered by the foreign bodies, for example, the use of the contact lenses, artificial eyes, prosthesis, as well as the use of the scleral buckles can initiate such a giant papillary conjunctivitis in the patients. We have another variant, which is known as phlyctenular keratoconjunctivitis. It is initiated due to a type 1, type 4 sensitivity reaction, and it is more prevalent in the younger age group, in the malnourished children. Living in the poor conditions, for example, the over-congested or the overpopulated conditions can basically flare up this kind of phlyctenular keratoconjunctivitis. Another variant is the contact dermatoconjunctivitis, and it is usually flared up by the use of the particular medicines that usually flare up such reaction. For example, it can be atropine or any other steroids which are used on regular basis can flare up such contact dermatoconjunctivitis. How do you deal with these conditions and what are the treatment guidelines that encompass such conditions would be dealt in over here in this lecture. We have a range of ophthalmopathies being discussed on our website. So do watch these lectures. Thank you for watching sqadia.com and get access to watch the complete lecture.